back. All right. So we're just going to bring the right knee in. All right. Pull it all the way into your chest. We're going to hold here for a couple deep breaths. Then go ahead and switch to the other side. Switch to the other side. And practice while we're here, while we kind of are crunching up and have our shoulders off the ground, practice pulling your belly button in towards your spine and pushing that small part of the back into the floor. So you're almost crunching and curling towards your knee, practicing pushing that small part of the back into the floor. Switch to the other side. All right, go ahead and tee those hands out to the side. All right. And we're going to do iron crosses here. So we're going to take that right foot, come across the body, and then go to the other side. And we're going to do 10 here, nice and slow, just getting some rotation in that spine, waking it up a little bit. And now bring those heels towards your butt. And we got 10 hip bridges here, and we're gonna hold for a 2 count at the top. So drive your hips up and squeeze, and then back down nice and slow. Drive your hips up and squeeze, back down. We're gonna do 10 here, holding for a 1, 2 at the top, and then back down. Really driving those heels in the mid part of the foot or the arch into the floor as you drive your hips up. You got a couple more here. All right, now, go ahead and straighten that left leg out. Right leg goes up in the air. Grab behind the knee, or just above the knee where the hamstring is. And we're going to bring that leg down, flex the toe back, and we're gonna straighten it out. All right, and we're gonna go 10 times here. So you're pulling the knee towards your chest, straightening that leg out. Stretching those hamstrings out, getting them warm. All right, go ahead and switch to the other side. Bring that left knee in, or the other knee in. Pull all the way in towards your chest. Straighten that leg out as much as you can. And each time trying to get it a little straighter as that hamstring starts to work and loosen up. All right, go and bring those feet down. We're gonna flip over onto our hands and our knees. All right, then we're gonna start with our bird dog. Extend that right arm out, get the bicep and shoulder up next to the ear, pull the shoulder back and activate those lats. Straighten that left leg out, driving the heel straight back. Make sure our hips aren't turned like this. Kind of level those out a little bit. Bring the elbow and knee together, press them together, create some heat and tension here. Holding for about 5 seconds. And then extend out, and we're gonna do 5 of those. You don't have to hold it each time. Just make sure that when you bring that elbow knee together, you're crunching in, pulling your belly button in, and then extending out. Make sure you're getting that arm up. All right, go ahead and switch to the other side. Extend the left arm out, drive that right heel back. Bring the elbow and knee together. And hold, pressing them together, crunching them together, extend out. We got 5 reps here. All right, now we're going to thread the needle. We're gonna place that left hand in front of the face, reach up with the right. A couple deep breaths here. Just let that chest open up. And then take that right hand, we're gonna reach all the way through. Shoulder to the ground, head to the ground. Let the back stretch a little bit here. Take a couple deep breaths. And then we're gonna reach up and then back through 5 times. Now we're gonna go ahead and go to the other side, place that right hand in front of the face, reach up with the left. A couple deep breaths here, opening up that shoulder, trying to get that chest opened up. And then take that hand, reach under, thread it through. Just hang out here, take about 3 deep breaths into this side body right here and hip. And then reach up, and then back under, and we're going 5 times here. All right, now we're going to lay face down, hands out to the side, and we're gonna be going side to side here. You're gonna bring the right hand in, roll over to that left shoulder, so you feel a stretch, take a nice deep breath, and then on your exhale, straighten that right arm out, bring the left in, and go to the other side. And we're gonna do 10 here. So take a deep breath in, and roll, exhale, go to the other side. Going side to side here, 10 times. Not static stretching, dynamically stretching the shoulder, the pec. Got a couple more here. All right. Come back to your hands and your knees. All right, we're gonna practice some lift-offs here. All right, so get those wrists under your shoulders, knees under your hips, tuck the toes, and all we're gonna do is lift off and then back down. So when you lift off, don't just raise your butt up and pick your knees up. Pull in with your belly button and try to keep that back somewhat flat. Okay, so you should be, your core should be nice and tight right here. Set it back down, lift off, set it back down, lift off. Now, what I want you to do, keep your core tight, and I want you to push yourself back into this squatted position, and then come back forward into that lift off position. Push back, and then forward. And notice how my knees are barely off the ground here. They're not way up here like this, my butt's not in the air. I'm down here, push back, my knees come off the ground here. When I come back forward, they shift back, or they're just hovering over the ground. Push back. Now, when we come through, I want you to take your right foot, step it to your right hand, and then take that left foot and kick it through and just tap the ground in front of you. All right, so that's our kick through. Then you bring your foot back, your hand down, come back into that little push and squat position. Go to the left side, kick the right foot through, tap it to the ground, step back, all right, and then come back to your hover position. The natural tendency here is when we kick through and come back, we straighten our legs out in the plank. Try to keep everything nice and tight here, as it'll throw off your movement, all right? So, go ahead and crunch here. We're gonna step that foot forward, slide that back leg out, and get into our runner's lunge here. And just hang out here for about 5 seconds. And then hip rotations. 5 one way. And then 5 the other way. Keep those hands on the ground. All right, we're gonna take that hip, not the one that's back here. We're gonna take it, we're gonna dip it down to the ground and open up this knee, and then come back up 5 times. Just a little twist here, a little stretch through the IT band, the TFL. All right, bring those hands back in. Step back, 20 mountain climbers. All right, now bring that left foot up next to the left hand. Hang out here for about 5 breaths. Hip rotations, 5 times one way. 5 times the other way. And then keep those hands on the ground, and we're gonna take that hip, dip it down towards the ground, open up the knee and the hip on the other side. 5 times here. Obviously, I don't have that much flexibility. Or my hip would touch the ground right here, and it doesn't. Step that foot back, and 20 more mountain climbers. Walk your hands to your feet. All right, now we're gonna go into our single leg touchdowns. Stand on that left leg. Pull those shoulders back and down, slight bend in the knee. Drive the hips back as you reach down. We're not reaching to the ground, about mid-shin, just below the knee. And then back up. We're going 10 times here. And then we're gonna do 5 with a hop at the end. And then 5 with a hop. Keeping the shoulders pulled back. Find your balance on those hops. Try to stick that landing. And then go to the other foot or other side. Really drive those hips back here. All right, don't just reach down like this. Take this leg, drive it back. Keep your back flat and then stand. Probably wasn't the best example there. And then 5 with a hop. All right, when you're done, widen those feet out. We're gonna go side to side a little bit, open up those hips and groin. All right, so we're just going to lower down as low as you can, comfortably. Come back up, squeeze your butt, go to the other side. Each time, trying to get a little bit lower as you loosen up here. We're doing 10, 5 on each side. That was 6 for me. Let's see if I can get lower on these next 4. And then bring those feet together and shake it out. We're gonna be starting off with a dead bug hold. So I want your toes flexed back towards you, about 90 degrees at the foot, 90 degrees at the knee, 90 degrees at the hips. And then when you get into that position, instead of leading with your face like this, I want you to lead with your chest and your fingertips. Keeping your head neutral and looking straight up at the ground. Once I say heel taps, you're gonna stay in this position and slowly tap the heels to the ground. We're not straightening the leg out and tapping down. We're keeping everything bent and just slowly tapping to the ground, okay? On our leg lifts, you can put your hands under your butt if you want. but we're going to start in this position here. You're gonna lower down all the way to the ground if you can, but if you feel anything in your lower back, keep your hands underneath your butt and only go to the point to where you know you don't feel any pain or anything in your lower back. All right, so if my range of motion is from here, I'm gonna come here and go 1, 2, 3 and stop and then back up, okay? But if you can go all the way to the ground, we're going 1, 2, 3 to the ground and coming back up. And notice I'm still in this hollow body position. I'm looking up, I'm still crunching up here, and I'm here. I'm not just collapsed on the ground, just throwing my feet up in the air, all right? And then we'll go into our side plank rotations. 30 seconds on each side, all right? So let's go ahead and get busy on this one. We're going in 10 seconds here. Starting off with that dead bug hold. Hopefully I don't pass out today. I've had to hit the inhaler a couple times. Allergies are nice and fun today. Go ahead and reach up and hold. Really pull that belly button in towards the spine, pushing the small part of the back into the floor, keeping your head as neutral as possible so that we don't create tension in the neck. We got 10 more seconds here. Take breaks as you need to. This isn't easy. 3, 2, 1, keep those knees bent and just tap down. And keep crunching up, staying in that dead bug hollow body position. Now you should start to feel it burn a little bit in that lower abdominal. Ten more seconds here. One more tap down and rest. All right, 30 seconds of rest. You can keep your hands out to the side on these leg lifts, or you can put them under your butt. It's up to you. You got 15 seconds here. So remember, it's slow down. 1, 2, 3 going down. As soon as you get to your point, whether it's the heels to the ground or that point where you have limitation, and go, and then crunch it back up. And both feet need to be pinched together and coming back up at the same time. We don't want to see this. All right, that means one side is working and doing all the work and the other side's taking a break. We don't want that. We're going for a whole minute here in case you're wondering why I haven't said stop yet. We're going another 10 seconds. One more. And rest. 30 seconds of rest. Then we're going to our side plank rotations. We're going to do 30 seconds on one side, 30 seconds on the other. Another 30 second rest. And we'll be done with that first round. All right, we're going in 10 seconds here, so make sure that elbow is right up underneath the shoulder. Feet are stacked. And if all you can do right here is hold plank, that's fine. If you can throw a rotation in, reach up nice and high and go. And get anywhere from 8 to 12 reps here. If you're going slow and letting the movement work for you, if you're just throwing your arms around, you might as well just hold side plank. One more here. Switch to the other side. Make sure you take an extra second here to make sure that elbow's right up underneath the shoulder so you're in good position. One more. And rest. 30 seconds here. We're going back to those dead bug holds and dead bug heel taps. Whew. Ten seconds. Get a feeling this one's gonna be a lot harder. Go ahead and get those feet up. Flex the toes back. Hands are out in front of you. You're gonna crunch up and hold. Try not to have those feet way out here. Don't have your feet together and your knees apart. Try to keep everything like going the same direction here. Okay. I'm not playing here. This is not comfortable. Like I said, every week, I gotta do more of this. Heel taps. Nice and slow here. It's not this, right? It's nice and slow, controlled. Let the muscles contract and work. You'll feel it more that way. And rest. All right, we got 10 seconds here. We have our leg lifts. Hands out to the side, feet together, up in the air, and go. Nice and slow going down, and then come up quick. Nice and slow going down. Come up quick. Remember, we're going for a minute here, so take breaks if you need to. I'm probably gonna need to after this next rep. Shake that out a little bit. Back up, right back to work. Whew. 15 seconds. Whew, I'm not done. 10 seconds. And rest. 30 seconds of rest. One second. All right, side plank. 3, 2, 1, and go. Reach under, tight behind you, and then back up. Make sure that this arm isn't sliding out here. Keep it tucked up underneath. Lats are nice and tight. Okay. Protect that shoulder. And switch. Stack those feet, make sure that elbow's right up underneath you. Reach up, and then get into your rotations. Try tapping your fingers on the ground behind you, and then reaching straight up. Make sure that when you come through, squeeze your butt forward, bring those hips forward, and rest. We don't want to be, see if I can do it this way. We don't want to be in our side plank and kind of doing one of these. All right? We want to try to keep it as straight as possible and get rotation through that core. All right, we're back to our dead bugs. 5 seconds. Wasn't very much of a rest, was it? All right, here we go. Flex those toes and reach up. Dead bug hold. Try not to get those feet too high in the air. Don't let them relax. Try to keep them parallel to the ground. We got 10 more seconds in this position before we go into our heel taps. Keep crunching up, pulling that belly button in, pressing the spine into the floor, and that lower back and heel taps. Even more important right here to really be pulling that belly button in, pushing the small part of the back into the floor. The more you pull that belly button in, the more you'll feel these heel taps. Take breaks as you need to. And rest. Tempo leg lifts next. Remember, we start up top, lower slow, and then crunch those feet, legs, everything up as fast as possible, and then slowly lower again. When you're pulling those feet up, that's when you pull your belly button in towards the spine and press the small part of the back into the floor so we're protecting your back. Right, feet up, crunch it up, and go. So coming down nice and slow, when we get ready to come up, really pull that belly button in and crunch those feet up. Seconds. Seconds. Five seconds. One more rep. 30-second rest. Ooh. We have 15 seconds here. We're into our side plank rotations. Go ahead and get set up. Make sure that elbow's right up underneath the shoulder. Stack those feet. Pull that down so that the lats and rib cage are nice and tight. All right, reach under and up. And here we go, 30 seconds on this side. You don't have to go fast here. Actually, the slower you go, the more it works. A dynamic isometric movement. 3, 2, 1, and switch to the other side. Make sure you're set up the right way. Elbows up underneath that shoulder, feet are stacked. Get into that side plank and get into those rotations. Get one more in and rest. All right, take 30 seconds here. Grab a sip of water. All right, while you're getting a sip of water there, we're gonna go over what these bear crawls, prisoner push-ups, and lunges should look like. We are gonna do our lunges to where we're making sure we're keeping our head up. They're pretty much called prisoner lunges, but we're just gonna call them lunges for the day since we already have prisoner push-ups, all right? But when we're doing our bear crawls, we're gonna walk forward 3 to 5 times depending on the space that you have, okay? And we're gonna do that lift off maneuver. So you're gonna be here, we're gonna lift our knees and hover, and this is our bear crawl position. We're not way up here like this and going, like that, okay? We want the quads, the hip flexors, and the core all engaged while we're doing this. So we're gonna lift off in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's one. Down and back is one. If you have a really small space and you only be able to go like 3 feet forward, 3 feet back, do an extra rep. If you can't do those because of shoulder issues, then just hold plank for 30 seconds and then go into your prisoner push-ups, or if you have a weight, you can do a chest press lying on your back instead of your push-ups. You can come here, you can get to that hollow body position right here and do six floor presses, okay? On your prisoner push-ups, you're gonna do your push-up, whether it's a regular push-up, and then drive a knee in. That's one. Other knee, two. Other knee, three. If you need to be on your knees to do your push-up, then you'll come up to plank. Back down. Back to plank. Okay? If you need to do hand release push-ups just at the top, you're driving one knee in. We're doing six of those. So three bear crawls, six prisoner push-ups. And then our lunges, they're just nine. And I understand it's not even on each side, but it will even out over the course of the workout. Hands are behind your head. Take a step forward or backward. Why do we keep our hands right here? It keeps us from leaning forward as we start to fatigue. All right, keeps that chest up. Those are our first three exercises. All right, the next part, we have three burpees. Everyone knows how to do a burpee. Come down, keep your core tight, especially as you press off the ground. All right, and a little hop at the top. Then we have six of our kip throughs. Going back into our bear crawl position or liftoff position. We're coming through, kicking through, come all the way back into this position here, and then come through. Come back, and then through. All right, each time you kick through is one rep. We're doing six of those. And then come to your feet, and we'll have jumping lunges. If lunges aren't in your cards for today, substitute lunges for squats and jumping lunges for squat jumps, okay? Even if you get into the workout and you're doing lunges and it starts to be uncomfortable, go ahead and switch over to squats, all right? So 3 minutes of work, 1 minute of rest, going through each circuit three times. We're going through the first circuit three times, then going through the second circuit three times. All right. Oops, hit the wrong button. All right. Going in 10 seconds here. Let's get ready. We're bear crawling, down, back, down, back, down, back. Then prisoner push-ups, and go. About five crawls forward, five crawls backwards. That's one. It doesn't have to be exact. Just want you to keep working on your form and keep moving through the workout, okay? Then get into your six prisoner push-ups. Then come to your feet, hands behind your head, and I'm gonna do reverse lunges, and you're alternating for nine. And then back to your bear crawls. Back to those prisoner push-ups. And then back to our lunges. Hands behind your head. Keep that chest opened up. Then back to your bear crawls. We have a minute. Seconds. Back to your prisoner push-ups. Seconds. Back to your lunges. Rest. One down, two to go. Whew. Shake those arms out. Oh. Man, shoulders are on fire. I don't know about you. Core is on fire. Legs are fine so far. Whew. We got 20 seconds. We're back into our next 3 minute piece. Again, if those shoulders really get lit up on you and it's hard to do these or you can't do them at all, just hold plank for 30 seconds and go. Hold plank for 20 seconds because that's how long that took. Six push-ups, push-up, knee drive, push-up, knee drive. And then those lunges with your hands up, elbows out for 9 reps. And then back to your bear crawls. One of these days I'll learn not to do bear crawls on this floor. It gets so slick. Whew. Once you're done with your bear crawls, back into those push-ups, whatever your modification is. Shake those arms out when you need to. Got 90 seconds here. Caught myself looking at the ground. So as my chest fell forward, try to keep your eyes looking straight ahead. Whew. After those lunges, back to the bear crawls. Got about 45 seconds here. Seconds. two, one, and rest. Shake those arms out. Whew. Only one more of those to go. Then we go to the fun one. Whew. Thirty seconds. I gotta find another lane to bear crawl in. All right, we got about 10 seconds here. This is our last 3 minutes of this piece. We're set. Go ahead and get your position. Lift off and go. Back to your push-ups. And then back to your lunges. Hands behind the head, chest up, elbows out. And then back to your bear crawls. Oh. Whew. Coming up on 90 seconds to go. And back to your 9 lunges. One minute to go. Back to our bear crawls. Ooh. Ooh. 30 seconds. Five seconds. And rest. We got 40 seconds here. Remember, we have 3 burpees, 6 kick throughs, 9 jumping lunges. Still 3 minutes to get as many rounds, as much work as you can. We got 15 seconds here. Seconds. Here's our first 3 minutes of the second set. And go. 3 burpees. Keep that core tight all the way down, all the way up on those burpees, and then back down get in your hover position. You're going to push back and kick through. And then six jumping lunges, or nine, sorry, nine jumping lunges. And then back to three burpees. Back to your kick throughs. Make sure you get a proper setup on these kick throughs. Ooh. I'm sliding a lot. Ooh, still got one more. Ooh, we got 1 minute here. In case you're wondering, yes, I'm struggling. Back to your burpees. We got about 30 seconds here. Whew. Make sure you get proper setup on your kick throughs. 15 seconds. Ooh, couldn't keep myself up. 3, 2, 1, and rest. No one said it was gonna be easy. You do what you can today. I'm struggling. I admit it. Ooh. One down, two to go. Starting back at the top. Ooh. 30 seconds. If the kick throughs are challenging for you, take your time through them. Do four instead of six if you need to, you know, until you find that rhythm. Unfortunately, we're going in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. 3 burpees. Six kick throughs. Get a proper setup there. It might be better to do two rest, because that sucked. Whew. 1 minute. 1 minute in, anyways. Not 1 minute to go. Huh. Six kick throughs. Kick all the way through, all the way back. Oh, press against the floor. Almost load your next movement. Ooh. Back to your nine jumping lunges. Ooh. 40 seconds here. Back to your three burpees. I'm going back to the front kick throughs. Whew. And rest. One minute of rest here. We got our last 3 minutes of work coming up. And we'll stretch it out. Whew. We were just talking about the challenges of body weight workouts Monday night. We got 20 seconds here. So our last 3 minutes of work before we cool down and stretch it out. All right, everyone, here we go. 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and go. Keep that core tight on those burpees. Back into those kick throughs. Back to your jumping lunges. Then back to your three burpees. Less than a minute. Three burpees. Whew. 40 seconds to go. Ooh. Ten seconds. And rest. Oh, take a minute. We're gonna stay standing for the first part of our stretching. I know we're probably right at 8:30. If you needed to leave to get on a call or work or something, make sure you stretch throughout the day. But we're going into, go ahead and stand up tall, right arm across the front, pull those shoulders down and away from your ears and face. Take that front hand, place it between the shoulder blades, pull back. Stretch out those triceps. All right, now straighten that right arm out, or that upper arm out. Grab behind the elbow or tricep. Pull to the side. Get a nice side body stretch here. About three breaths. Breathing into that side body. If your breaths are kind of upbeat still, because you're still trying to catch your breath, do five deep breaths here. And bring those arms down, shake it out. And we're gonna go to the other side. Left arm across the front, pull the shoulders down and away from the ears and the face. Take that front hand, place it between the shoulder blades, pull back, stretching out those triceps. All right, now straighten that arm out, grab behind the elbow or the back of the arm on the tricep, pull to the side, keep that chest opened up, and focus on breathing into the side body right here 3 to 5 times. On each exhale, pull a little bit, get a little extra stretch. If you want, you can drop that outside arm to get a little bit more stretch. Come back to the top, take those hands, clasp them behind your back, press down in the back. I'm going to stretch the neck out just in case we were shrugging in our burpees and our bear crawls and our kick throughs and we weren't in an active position, we got tired and we started getting in this position. All right, we want to make sure we stretch those traps out. Dip the right ear, right shoulder. Then we're going to dip the chin down, go to the left side. Keep pressing down in the back. Dip the chin to the right. Dip the chin to the left. We're going to do each of those one more time. Dip the chin to the right. Keep pressing down so we don't shrug. Dip the chin to the left. Now we're gonna bring that head to the upright position. Now we're going to take the chin, turn and tuck it to the right shoulder as we press down. And go to the left side. And we're gonna go back and forth here 3 times. Just getting a little different stretch through the traps and the neck. All right, and then we're gonna make our way down to the ground. If you have a mat, it'll help cushion the knees a little bit. We're gonna widen our feet out, bring our toes in into like this wide child's pose here. We're gonna reach out in front, get into that child's pose, drive the hips into the heels, hold here for about 3 to 5 breaths.
you want to hold here for another couple of breaths, you can. I'm going to take my right hand out to the right side, stack the left on top. And then here, I'm going to focus on driving my left hip into my left heel as I breathe out. So nice deep breath in. And then on the exhale, try to sink that left hip into the left heel. Do that 3 to 5 times on this side. Slowly walk it over to the left, right hand on top. If you need more time on that other side, stay there. 3 to 5 deep breaths on this side. And we're gonna walk it back to the middle. We got one last stretch here. We're gonna stay in this wide knees here. You can probably go out a little bit wider. And then we're gonna widen our feet out just outside our knees, all right? And then we're gonna come down to our elbows, hang out here, and then we're gonna slowly walk back until we find some tension in the groin, hips, low back, and then give way just a little bit here. And we're gonna hang out here for about a minute, minute and a half, 2 minutes. All right, and this is gonna open up those hips, stretch the hamstrings, stretch the hips, hip flexors. And just focus on your breath here. Take about 20 deep, controlled breaths. Each time on your exhale, trying to get a little bit more of your hips back towards the wall or your heels. I'm just now on my 10th breath, and that was 45 seconds. So 10 more breaths at that rate. About 3 or 4 more deep breaths here. Two more deep breaths. So on this last one, when you breathe in on your exhale, I want you to come out nice and slow going forward. Just walk it forward, slowly bring those hips to the ground, walk the feet in, and kind of shake that out just a little bit, hips side to side. Oh. Not that you didn't have a choice but to come out forward, but.